in the day, actually, isn't it?
No. 20 past 11.
It's close to midday. Anyway, I have had a bit of a wobbly morning. I've been so tired and a bit anxious. And so Jordan has gone out on his own, did some walking.
Just went on a morning walk.
And I stayed. I got up early, but I just kind of just relaxed and regenerated.
Picked up some coffee, but you didn't like yours, did you?
Boy, it had cinnamon in it. It was really weird. We have just got off the underground, the subway, from
Times Square.
Now we are, what's it called, Rector Street?
Yeah, Rector Street. It's basically the one before the ferry over to Staten Island.
Yeah, Staten Island ferry. And we are going to go and walk around Wall Street and like the, what's it called?
The New York Stock Exchange.
We're going to walk around there, then we're going to head down to the ferry. Yeah, get on the ferry, do the Statue of Liberty, come back up. We're going to go to the World Trade Center. And we're going to, I'm really excited for that actually. We're going to go to like the Memorial Museum thing, and I'm really looking forward to that. Then we're going to head up. I want to do Soho, I want to do Chinatown, I want to do West and East Village, but I don't think we'll be able to do it all today because I'm absolutely shattered. Anyway,
I'm sure we will. It's all on the way home.
Yeah.
Even if we just do it briefly, at least we can say we've done it.
Yeah, exactly. Anyway, thought we would update you. Ciao, Bella.
Bye.
So we are at the New York Stock Exchange. Pretty massive building.
Huge.
But surprisingly quiet. I mean, I guess everyone's working, but there's so many people around here. I thought it was going to be a lot busier.
Yeah, same. I mean, just saying how, like, it's very fumey in New York. Yeah, like,
especially when you walk over the drains, you just smell of underground afterwards.
Yeah. I don't know how people don't get really sick here. It's so fumey.
Pretty cool place here.
Yeah, it's lovely.
And it's slightly quieter than the main, like, roll around Times Square. So it's actually quite nice.
And it's the buildings are beautiful. Like, look how gorgeous that building is. And like down there, well, it's just lovely. We just went into TJ Maxx just to see what it's like because it's TK Maxx in England.
Wasn't any good.
It's good. It was so big. Just didn't want anything. We are walking along this riverbed. We're walking down to the Staten Island ferry. Just been in Tiffany's on Wall Street. Have a look at the engagement rings.
Didn't find any we like, unfortunately.
No, I found a lovely one. There's such lovely rings in there. I bet they're so expensive, but you never know. Am I worth it? I like to look, maybe get some ideas in his head. Yeah, we're walking down to the ferry now. We're going to get the ferry and then we're going to have a lovely time.
We are indeed.
I'm tired though, I've got something in my eye as well. Ah!
We are on the ferry, outdoor seats. Pretty cold to be fair, especially now we're out of the sun. But we've literally just pulled out of the...
port.
Yeah, well, I guess you call it a port. But look at this view.
Look how stunning that is. I don't want to drop my phone. Look at it. So pretty.
So, as you can see, we're just going past the Statue of Liberty. And it is absolutely freezing. We're still on this boat. The wind is so, so cold.
It's cold, it's so cold. Here we are. Look how cool. Very zoomed in. I don't even think I'll be able to see you. Look how cool that is. We've come to the front. It is so chilly. Gorgeous though. What bridge is that over there? What bridge is that? people.
All of the names.
We just read all of the names.
This was just one of the towers.
Is there like this spot where the other one is as well? So is this like all of the names from the building that gets built?
I'm not too sure.
So we're looking at this side now. We were over there a minute ago, but we're looking here now. And these are all the people on flight 77. There's the other flight over there. But I feel like I've heard of that name. I don't know why. But we're trying to look for people with the same surname. George W. Simmons, Diane M. Simmons, Dana Falkenberg, Zoe Falkenberg and Charles Falkenberg. That's really sad because they're probably like a family, and like the amount of people that like these people's families would have lost three of them. So sad. Look at this squirrel. This is so funny. Is that proper eating his nut? He's just sat there on this little perch. That is so funny. Look how small he looks. It's funny, isn't it?
We love squirrels.
We do. We always love watching squirrels. This is the view at 8:30 in the morning on September the 11th, 2001. We are in Chipotle, and I had one Chipotle in Paris once, and that was it, and it was the same as this. This looks unreal. I can't wait to eat it. It's like
and we are starving.
I've got queso, cheese, and salad.
Cheers.
We are in a place, where are we right now? Oh, you can't even see it. We are in the Black Iron Burger, and it is...
I'm having a salad.
Cam's having a salad with organic chicken. We're having Parmesan truffle fries. Jordan's got a chicken burger. Is it good?
Yeah, really good.
And then I have got a veggie burger with American cheese and loads of pickles, which I take out half of them and eat them on the side because I love them so much. And yeah, it's lovely. Good morning.
Guten Morgen.
Good morning, everybody. So it is our second to last day here. Well, it's our last full day here.
It's our last proper day.
Last proper day. You can't even see you, so blurry over there. It's our last proper day, and we have just gotten ready. So it is about 8:30, and we are leaving now. We're gonna have a really super busy day, aren't we?
Yeah, we've got lots of walking to do.
Yeah.
I mean, we're pretty much walking half the length of like Manhattan and New York and doing a big loop.
Yeah.
And that's just the first half of the day.
So we are staying in Times Square, just outside of Times Square. So we are going to walk down to the Empire State Building, go to Macy's, which is like right next to it. And then we're gonna go down towards the Flatiron Building. And then we're gonna keep going to where?
West Village, Soho and Chinatown.
There was something else I wanted to do on the way. But yeah, we're going to West Village.
We're going to the Arch.
And Chinatown. And then possibly East Village as well. And then come back. Then we want to go to Fifth Avenue later on if we have time. I want to go to Lululemon and get some shorts. And that's...
I need to buy that hat from there.
Yeah. One thing to note as well, I don't know whether you can tell. So firstly, my straighteners won't work in the blooming plugs because the like voltage is too high or something like that. So that's really annoying. So I haven't been able to do my hair since we got here. Secondly, look at the state of my hair. Look how dry it is. Like, you can literally see. My hair's not normally like that. And I washed it last night and now it's so dry. It's like, feels disgusting. And I used all of like the normal stuff on it. I've put loads of oil on it and it just looks like that. So luckily I'm getting my hair cut on Friday, so it'll be chopped off till about there, so all that dead stuff will be gone. But yeah, it's really sad, and now my hair looks like crap.
Good morning. We are here outside the Empire State to, I think, a disappointed Talitia.
I'm not disappointed, I thought, yeah, maybe a little bit disappointed. We've just been walking for ages and my face is all like numb and cold and I'm hungry now, so it looks good.
I mean, I think when we're slightly further away, obviously, it will look a little bit better because we are directly underneath it.
I think it just seems like another building. Like, the Rockefeller was like, it was obviously like a really cool building, if that makes sense. Like the new World Trade Center, that was also like another cool, like they all like kind of
unique,
yeah, like separate it out from like every other normal building. This one just feels like a normal building. Yeah,
this one's kind of like blended in with all the other buildings. I mean, unfortunately, we're not going up the top of this one. Don't think we really need to. But yeah, we'll get to a bagel, get a bit further away, and maybe we'll be able to appreciate it a little bit more.
Yeah, I guess because I can't really see it either. So we've come to Flaxseed bagels. Got two coffees and a bagel. I got a veggie with cream cheese or something like that. John got what?
I got, I think it's pastrami, two eggs and cheddar on an everything bagel.
We are at the Flatiron building now. John said it was boring. It is boring, but it's okay.
Yeah, I mean,
at least we've seen it, you know.
It's kind of having some work done as well, which makes it even less good.
It's very thin though. It's like that really thin building in London. I don't know, it's like, you know, that's a really thin building in London.
Yeah.
It's like the thinnest like house or something like that.
It is a flat iron building.
Anyway, let's go.
Next stop is West Village, I believe.
This is really cool. We're at Washington, what's it called? Washington Park? Arch? The arch is over there, but we just ran down here because there's a few, I don't know whether you can hear me, there's a few like people doing drugs and it's a bit scary. Anyway, so we've just walked to this bit and look at all this. It's so sweet. Chessboards everywhere with benches so people can come and play. There's a couple of people over there playing and there's some chess pieces set up. It just looks so sweet. What a lovely idea. Like, it's just, I just love it. My brother used to play chess and he was a champion and he would love this.
I've got a paper watcher. There's a couple of people just arguing over there and they've been arguing for a long time, so I just, you know.
Yeah, they've been shouting and their dogs are going crazy. There's like a Doberman and like something else.
A Rottweiler
and their dogs are going crazy. It's really, that's why we ran, because there was people doing drugs over there. There was people arguing. It was a little bit scary. Let's go, Geordie. So we are just heading to West Village now. It's not that far at all. We've walked for so long today. It's like 11 o'clock.
Yeah, we've been walking for a good two and a half hours.
2.5 hours, yeah. No, about 2 hours because we got lunch.
We aren't even where we're planned on starting doing our route/slash journey for the day, so we've got a lot to do still.
Yeah.
I think we're going to pick up the pace and stop like dawdling about popping into shops.
Yeah, we keep going into shops, and there was we went into H&M. Anyway, that was really awkward. Some woman just stopped and just started staring at us, so I got really awkward. So we were in H&M. We were just like having a look because I've been trying to find some pants. Some underwear this whole time because I need to take some travelling and I haven't been able to find any. So we're in H&M looking, and Jordan, like, I've got really dry face. Like, I don't know if you can tell, but I've got a load of like Vaseline all over my chin and everything because my face is so dry and so sore. And Jordan went to go and touch it and literally gave me the biggest electric shock ever. And you could see, you heard it, like it was loud, wasn't it? And you could see the like lightning, I swear, and it hurt so much. And I literally instantly started crying in the middle of H&M because it hurt so much and it shocked me so much. I just started crying, didn't I?
Always one.
This street is pretty chaotic, isn't it, Jordan? It's really cool.
So busy.
Very crowded, actually. We're in between Little Italy and Chinatown. It's really weird. One side, literally, is the Italian shops, and the other side, we've got Chinese shops. It's very cool.
Yeah, one side is Italian shops, and then the other side.
Yeah. Hey, are you looking for watches?
Oh, no, thank you. See, everyone just, like, heckles you. It's crazy.
No, thank you.
That was absolutely hectic. But what we were saying is one side, we walked up there and one side was like Italian, one side was like Asian. Now it's time to find some food, isn't it, sir?
Absolutely, I'm hungry, but I'm not gonna overfill myself like I have done every other lunch.
I really fancy soup dumplings. I've never ever had them. I really want to try them. I want, I don't mind sushi, but I'd prefer like dumplings and stuff. So yeah, now, we're walking through. Look at this dragon fruit. This is really cool, it's like a little market. Bakery, farms, these are like proper authentic like Asian stores, food shops. This is where I wanna go. Vegetable dim sum, they're green.
I've got pork.
We're in Macy's.
It's very loud in here, isn't it?
It's huge.
I've got the sorest lips ever. We just went into Ulta because my face is so flipping dry that I've got a face mask for the plane tomorrow. And I couldn't tap the contactless thing. I had no idea where it was.
Oh, Apple. But we bought some new mugs. Two new mugs.
We'll show you them when we get
home. And they're very special mugs.
So we are out for our final meal. We're at Virgil's barbecue house.
Virgil's, that was. Not yeah, Virgin's.
It smells so good in here. It's so busy. The menu, amazing.
I wish I took a clip of the menu.
Yeah, not so great for obviously vegetarians. Yes. However, there's so much choice here. And so many sides, so many like starters. You're never gonna be short on food.
There's nothing for me really, but that's okay.
That's now half full.
And it's not that too. It's not that expensive for like the bit. It's not too bad. It's like £25 for your chicken main thing.
Yeah, just like considering $25. How big the portions are, which you'll see.
Right, we've just been interrupted, but that's in a positive way.
As I was saying, portions humongous. This is a starter. It's not a main course, it's a starter, and it's humongous.
It's massive. That is literally, it doesn't even...
And it smells absolutely incredible.
It does.
So I cannot wait to tuck in, because, you know, it's been a while since vape, so we're pretty hungry, I think.
This is my salad. Lovely salad.
Just putting out there, we have ate so many fries.
Yeah, we've had so many.
They've been in front of us for a good 15 minutes, 20 minutes.
Yeah.
Like we've been eating like non-stop.
Jordan's chicken.
Still, yeah.
The camera is so bad at the moment.
Half a chicken. Neither of us have had. Well, I haven't had a biscuit in a long time.
I've never tried one.
So we decided to go for some biscuits, obviously because we have the chips to start, and of course the mac and cheese. We've also got a couple more drinks on the way, which will be amazing. But everything looks amazing.
Everything does look good. It's very early this morning. It's about 7 o'clock so far, and we are on our way to Central Park to get a coffee and walk around for the sunrise.
Yeah, we're gonna get rent a couple of bikes, hopefully watch some sort of sunrise, if it's sunny enough, grab a coffee, probably a quick bite to eat, because we've got to get back to the hotel for 11 for checkout, and then we'll have a couple more hours of exploring before we head off this afternoon.
We are here for our final lunch. We are at a place called Carmine's, and it's an Italian restaurant, and honestly, when you see the size of the portion, you will be amazed. But
I think I've seen this place on TikTok before. We were going to come here the other day, but decided not to because it looked really expensive, and then realised that it's a family-style restaurant, so it's like you order one plate to share, like it's that big. So that's why it's so expensive. Oh my gosh, it's sangria, it's lovely. Got like a quartino of red wine, because it's our last day, so why not? And then John's got beer, and we've got rigatoni with broccoli coming.
But bearing in mind, it's only just midday. This place is heaving. And it's massive. We'll show you when the food arrives.
Look at our food, it's come. This thing was full and then the guy dished it out for us. But we've got like two full plates and that. Well, we've still got all of that
the
there.
The size of the bowl compared to my hand.
It is massive.
It's huge.
Hello everybody. We have finished our dinner now and we have to talk to the Grand Central Station because we just thought, what should we do? And then I thought all of a sudden, oh my gosh, we're only like 10 minutes away from the Grand Central Station.
And we haven't actually seen it yet.
We haven't actually seen it, and it's Gossip Girl, literally first episode, Gossip Girl, and then obviously Madagascar's in Grand Central Station. One thing we didn't do was the zoo, and I wanted to do that actually, but we don't have time now, so whatever. I am actually a little bit sad that we didn't do this. It says Luke's over there.
I don't know if that.
It could be completely wrong, but it could be like Luke's guy from Gilmore Girls, you don't know. But this is really cool. I'm glad we came here. This is the most surreal moment. I'm pretty sure, and I might be wrong, but this is where Gossip Girl was filmed, the first episode. Sabrina was on that side, there was a clock there, I swear, I haven't watched it in quite a few years, but I swear there was like a clock there, and then she was like stood up on top and she was like looking over. I swear, and this is very exciting. Finally here, and this is where in Madagascar they're all like, whoa! And they shoot them and it's like, start spreading the news and it goes really, really fast because they go all dizzy from the shot, from the, what's it called? Tranquilizers. And then the lady beats them up with a handbag. I think this is it, I don't know. Anyway, I'm gonna pretend that it is, and let's go.
So we have just got to the airport and we were just planning on going to Dunkin' Donuts just for a coffee and maybe like a pastry, but it was shut. And now we've ended up coming to probably the most expensive restaurant in the airport, and look at the size of this meal we have before we board the plane. Is it good? Eat it. But we're happy. Beautifully cooked.
Hands down, the best burger I've ever had in my whole life. I am not even joking. This is so thin and tasty. I've got a Beyond burger. It's literally cooked to perfection. Onions, tomatoes, lettuce, cheese, like lots of other cheese, garlic aioli. The bun is just so nice, honestly. It's just, oh, I love it.
Massive.
It's huge. absolutely massive and I'm already full, so I'm going to ask if I can wrap that up for the plane. Why not? I paid for it.